for himself, Gene Tracy.
Oh, yeah. Thank you very much. We're going to have us another wild time tonight. Appreciate it. Nice to be back in Charlotte, here at the House of State. Here in Charlotte, North Carolina, he told the truth. My name is Gene Tracy, and I do the truck stop tape. As a matter of fact, tonight we're putting on tape truck stop number 13. And before we get involved, I always have a little word of warning I like to throw out. If there's anybody here that's easily embarrassed, or if anybody has any hang-ups concerning their religion or their race or about any physical abnormalities or mental disorders about which they're particularly sensitive, you're probably better off going to the shit house now, because it ain't going to get no fucking better than this. I just lay it out on the table, let everybody look at it, and we talk about it, turn it over and look to the other side, see if it's sunburned. I've been known to measure it, and I talk about everybody. I try not to miss anybody. Talk about the Mexicans and the Puerto Ricans, call them spicks. Talk about the Jewish people, call them heebs. Talk about the black people, call them spades. Talk about people from Mississippi, Alabama, and South Georgia, call them rednecks. Talk about people from up north, call them Yankees. Talk about the Italians, call them dagos. Talk about the politicians, call them sons of bitches. In other words, I more or less talk the same way here that you do at home. Try to make you feel a little more comfortable, a little more at ease. Matter of fact, the only people I don't fuck with are the Polacks, because God knows they've had it up to here. Everybody does a number on the Polacks. No, I really. I cut that shit out about 3 months ago. If you recall, the Polish Anti-Defamation League had a march on the White House in protest of the Polish stories, and I don't blame them at all. They were getting out of hand. As a matter of fact, they marched all the way from Arlington, Virginia, onto the White House. At the last report, they were spotted some 13 miles south of Phoenix. I don't know what went wrong, but if they want to march, piss on them. In a fucking manner, and let them walk around the world. Who gives a shit? So I don't do Polish stories. However, I did find out why Polish children don't play in sandboxes. You see, the cats keep covering them up. Hey! Yeah! Heard about Polak is jacking off, change hands, and forgot what he's doing. about the Polish, two Polish surgeons performed the first successful hemorrhoid transplant. Shit, I ain't gonna explain them, I just tell them. Heard about the Polish surgeon that performed the first successful Peter transplant, and the other Polak's hand rejected it. Yeah. Heard about Polak traded his wife in on an outdoor toilet. Said the hole was smaller and it smelled better. Shit, ain't that awful? I hate that. About Polak came home, told his wife, said, "Honey, I bought us a condominium." She said, "Good, I was getting tired of using that goddamn diagram." Or about Polak's playing the Italians football. They had the playing field right near a railroad track, and the train came by, blew its whistle. The Italians thought it was halftime, walked off the field, and just 6 plays later, the Polak's got a touchdown. Yeah. Heard about Polak, the farmer, walked up to his neighbor and said, "Hey, guess how many pigs my old sow had, and I'll give y'all 9 of them." I pull off and went ice fishing, brought back 1,000 pounds of ice. And then his wife drowned trying to fry it. About 3 Polacks that went bear hunting. And as out in the woods, they had to cross this little country road. They seen a sign. Said, "Bear left." They said,
had piss on it, got in her car and went home. Two Polacks, such dedicated, avid deer hunters. Every day of deer season in Poland, they is out together hunting. One day, one guy accidentally shot his friend. And even into the next day, he was still in the waiting room of the emergency wing of the Polish hospital. About 4 o'clock in the afternoon, the doctor came through the swinging doors, taking off his surgical mask, removing his surgical gloves. The Polak jumped up and said, "How's my friend? Is he all right?" Doctor said, "Well, I'll tell you one thing. It's been nip and tuck. Nip and tuck. Goddamn, ever since you brought him in, just nip and tuck." Polak jumped up and said, "Well, how is he? Is he going to live?" Doctor said, "I'll tell you one fucking thing. It sure as hell been nip and tuck. Goddamn, if I don't believe we'd have had a better chance at it if you hadn't gutted him before you brought him in." Hurry up! My Polak broke his arm raking leaves. Fell out of a tree. My Polak is sitting in the bar. Look down the bar, 4 or 5 stools. It's good-looking, bro. Polak told the waiter, "Since I want to buy that girl a drink." Waiter said, "Man, you don't want to fuck with her. She's a lesbian." Polak said, "Well, shit. You know, people can't help things like that. Go ahead and give her a drink anyway." Bartender took her a drink. She looked up, picked her drink up. Polak looked down and said, "Hey, lesbian, how's everything in Beirut?" As some of you may know, I work quite often at the Follies Lounge in Atlanta, Georgia, at 8th and Peach Street, quite often in Washington, D.C., at the Boardroom Lounge on Vermont between K and L. There's a story going around Washington, D.C. about the last Congress becoming concerned over the pollution in the Potomac River, and they sent to Alaska and had flown down 100,000 coho salmon, a type of scavenger fish, and they dumped it in the Potomac in the hopes that they'd clean it up. They sent to Michigan. They have a type of pike called a walleye. They flew down 100,000 walleye, dumped them in the river. They also didn't clean it up, but the coho and the walleye got together, came up with a little fish called a co-wall. And that also didn't clean it up, so they sent to northern Illinois and flowed down 100,000 muskie. Now the coho, the walleye, and the muskie have got together to have a little hybrid fish called a kowalskie. It will eat shit, but they're having a hard time teaching it how to swim, I understand. It's a big problem, but they'll get it worked out, I'm certain of that. Incidentally, my home state is Oklahoma. I always try to find out if we ever get any Okies. Anybody from Oklahoma here tonight? Any Okies here tonight?
Yeah.
Oh, bullshit. There ain't that many. You from Oklahoma, sir? What part? Tulsa. Very good. Did you ever fuck a hot watermelon? I know a lot of them guys from up around. Listen, no, if you ever go to the market and they got Oklahoma watermelons on sale, if you find one that's been plugged, don't buy it. From Tulsa, is that right, sir? Yes, sir. You know what they call an Indian that doesn't have any balls? That's a squaw. See, we know about all that shit in Anadarko. You heard about the dumbass Indian that couldn't tell heads from tails. God damn, y'all have seen some of the scalps he is coming back into camp with. Some of them had holes in them that big. God damn, sing. Others had little handles on them. It's cute. Out of dark old Oklahoma. Had a salesman one time from Dallas driving up through Oklahoma. And his car broke down, pulled up to a farmhouse. he could spend the night. He said, yeah. I said, I want you to know I'm a bachelor. I only got one bed. We'll have to sleep together, but I guess it'll beat the shit out of that old car of yours. So they went to bed about 8:30, and this salesman was used to staying up late. And he turned to the farmer. He said, damn if it ain't slow around here. He said, what do y'all do for fun around here? And the farmer said, well, we do play a little pasture football every now and again. Salesman said, what do you mean, pasture football? Oklahoma farmer said, well, I'll just show you how we play it. Lifted one leg, went 7 points. Salesman wasn't to be outdone, went 7 up. Farmer went 14-7. Salesman 14-all. Farmer went just shit all over. Damn. Salesman said, God damn. What does that mean? Farmer said, well, that means it's halftime. Now we change sides. Yeah. Had a lot of things like that happen back in the... I remember when I was a kid, 16 years old. My daddy told me one time, said, son, said, Grandpa's going to come spend the night day with us today, and you're going to have to sleep with Grandpa tonight. I said, well, that ain't too bad. Me and Grandpa went to bed about 3 o'clock. I was about 16. About 3 o'clock in the morning, Grandpa raised up in the bed, said, bring on the girls. I told him, now, Grandpa, you turn loose of that. That there's mine. Oh, I remember one time my Uncle John named Jules sitting up on the porch there just out of Cement, Oklahoma. And there's a damn motor out on that old country road. There's a damn motorcycle come by at 180 miles an hour. Neither one of them had ever seen a motorcycle before. Jules turned to John and said, John, what's that coming down the road so fast? And Uncle John said, damn if I know. But it's got a holt of a man, ain't it? Went inside, got his double barrel shotgun, came out, sat down in his chair, leaned the double barrel shotgun up against the wall. About 30 minutes, here come this son of a bitch back down the road, leveled off at 162 miles an hour. Grandpa picked up that double barrel with wham! Let go both barrels. Grandma said, did you get him, Grandpa? Grandpa said, goddamn, Father, no. I sure as fuck made him turn loose that man he had a hold of. Yeah. Had a cousin lived up there in Chickasha, Oklahoma. He's out with the girl where he's getting ready to marry with. He's gone. Goddamn, he'd gone with her 2 months. Getting ready to marry, and she'd been pranking around a little more, actually, than she should be. She wanted to try to trick him a little bit. She went down to the drugstore, got 2 reels of adhesive tape, and taped it all together, all but just one little place. Now, he took her out that night, took her downtown Chickasha, bought her an RC and a moon pie. They went out by the Washita River, just coming on dark, got in the back seat, started playing around. He started to get a little. She had too goddamn much tape on, he couldn't get in. He said, honey, said, I believe I have some penetrating oil in the trunk. Let me see if I can find that. Went back to the truck, came back with the penetrating oil. While he was gone, she decided she'd help him a little bit, pull off a little piece of that tape. Came back with the penetrating oil felt, and when she pulled that tape, all the goddamn tape came off. About that time he showed up with the penetrating oil, feeling around, gave one little squirt of penetrating oil. Next time he went in, goddamn, it's like he's walking through the Holland Tunnel. The next day, he got to studying on that, and is out in the front yard cutting grass, swinging this swing blade hotter than hell. He's sweating. Goddamn skeeters about to eat him up. Gnats buzzing around. He reached back and slapped the back of his neck, grabbed a little gnat, pulled it out, looking at his little old wings just a-flopping, its legs just a-kicking. My cousin looked at that little gnat and said, "You little motherfucker, if I had my goddamn penetrating oil with me, I'd squirt some on the handle of this sling blade and stick it right up your ass." Yeah! Story about the truck driver. Truck broke down a little old country road down in Oklahoma, went up, knocked on the door. Farmer come to the door, he said, "Hey, I got trouble." Said, "I need some place to stay." Farmer said, "Well, you're welcome to stay here." Said, "All our kids is gone. We got plenty of room. It's just me and Ma." They went in that night and had supper, and then after supper, they're sitting out on the front porch. The farmer's sitting in a rocking chair, spitting tobacco juice over the rail, and the truck driver was sitting on the porch, 1 foot on the step. He is smoking his cigarette, and under the porch was these two old hound dogs. You could look back through the house, and there was Ma back in the kitchen washing supper dishes. All of a sudden, Grandpa lifted up on one cheek, went, let a fart you could hear in the next county. When he did, them two goddamn hound dogs come 26 inches off the ground. Their legs started spinning, and when they hit the ground, they was out across the front lawn, over the fence, across the road, over the next fence, through the cotton patch, down the holler, across the creek, and they's gone out the woods. Salesman looked at the farmer, said, "What the fuck's wrong with them dogs?" Farmer said nothing. "See what it is, Ma in there is hard of hearing, and every time she smells a fart, she thinks one of them dogs is shit under the house and beats the hell out of both of them." Kid, we used to listen to all them sermons on the radio, all that preaching on the radio. I'll never forget one time I was over at Uncle John and Aunt Jude's, and I said, "Now they was listening to this religious program, and the preacher said, now that you've got your $10 in the envelope, everybody put your right hand on the radio and the left hand on the afflicted part of your body, and I'll heal you." So Aunt Jewel put her right hand on the radio and her left hand on her heart, and Uncle John put his right hand on the radio and his left hand in his crotch. And Aunt Jill looked at him and said, "Damn, John." He said, "He is going to heal the sick, not raise the dead." You know what I mean? Yeah. Back on truck stop number 11, we was talking about a girl from back in Anadarko, Oklahoma, named Buma Dean Sclevage. And I was telling you about how ugly she was. Buma Dean was what you'd call an Oklahoma two-sacker. That means you got to put a sack on your head in case hers comes off. She's ugly girl. Damn, she's ugly. No shit, she is so goddamn fat, if anybody'd ever told her to haul ass, she'd had to make two trips. Big, ugly. Damn right. There in El Reno, Oklahoma, they got a truck stop just a little bit west of El Reno. They got a waitress working there at that truck stop. For those of you who stopped in, you probably know. Very, very well-known girl throughout those parts. Her name was Betty Goble. And damn, I used to like to watch her on Sunday, because on Sundays, They always served watermelons. And Betty used to just love to take them watermelon rinds, put them in the garbage disposal, turn the switch on, and lean up against the counter. Now, goddamn girls, you know how that'll get you off. That's how it gets started. Shit, that's better than having a vibrator with a 35-horsepower motor on it. You can strap to your back. Goddamn. Yeah, we had a girl back in Anadarko named Kay Weatherford, ugly son of a bitch, mean as a snake, and she was in a fourth grade play one time, and she played the part of Little Red Riding Hood. Little old flaky Kay Weatherford was skipping out across the stage, and the wolf jumped out and said, "Little Red Riding Hood, I'm going to eat you up." Kay said, "Eat, eat, eat. Don't anybody fuck anymore." Yeah. Oh, yeah. First trucking company I ever worked for in my life was Leeway Trucking Company out of Oklahoma City. I remember we had a trucker there named Renee Weatherby. Some bitch wouldn't drive nothing but Ford equipment. That's all that some bitch would drive. God damn, you talk about a horny truck. That son of a bitch would get up to look at the crack of dawn. Now, he was horny. Bad old son of a bitch. He was telling me one time, he's talking a high-class truck stop down in southern Oklahoma, down near Norman. Pulled in, and it's a high-class, instead of waitresses, they had waiters. And they had a great big sign out front said, "All this food untouched by human hands." The waiters, everything they'd bring, they'd pick up off the tray and set on the table with tongs. And they'd take the little bran muffins and use tongs just to sanitize. And I remember Renee asked one of them, said, "Hey," said, "y'all never touch nothing." He said, "No, sir, we're not allowed to." He said, "Well, what's them little strings hanging out you fly?" He said, "Well, like I told you, we ain't allowed to touch nothing. When we got to take a piss, I have to go back and pull my Peter out with that string and piss." Renee said, "Damn, that ain't unusual." Said, "How do you get your Peter back in?" He said, "Well, I usually use the tongs." Hoy! Heard about the truck driver from McLean Trucking Company. Guy named Bustney was out in the woods rabbit hunting. Come on, these two Carolina truck drivers, old Charlie and Roofer, is out there, and they both of them have their breeches and their drawers down around their ankles. The old Roofer had Charlie bent over a log, just stabbing him in the ass. Busby walked up and said, "God damn, what's going on here?" Roofer said, "Well, Charlie had a heart attack, and I'm trying to revive him." Busby said, "Well, God damn, if you ain't going at it wrong." Said, "What you're supposed to do is lay him on his back and give him mouth-to-mouth resuscitation." Roofer said, "Shit, that's how we got started." Yeah. Uh-huh. Little truck stop just on 995, just north of Washington, D.C. I was in there one time, truck driver, black truck driver named Quincy Proctor. Ugly motherfucker, skinny, goddamn, he was ugly. Came in, he was telling me about how he got a job driving for McLean truck line. Said he didn't know shit about it. He went up and told him his truck driver and the foreman took him out, put him up in the tractor and said, asked him, said, "Hey, you know how to double clutch?" Quincy said, "You ain't bullshitting me. One of them motherfuckers is a brake." Shit, I ain't been right. Down in Atlanta, I know a black truck driver. Marvin Levine is his name. His mama was a black woman and his daddy was Jewish. Marvin came home one time and said, "Mama, am I more Jewish or more black?" His mama said, well, I don't know, son. Perhaps you better ask your daddy. His daddy came home. He said, Daddy, am I more Jewish or more black? Daddy said, well, son, I ain't thought too much about it. Said, I don't know that it makes a hell of a lot of difference. Said, why do you want to know? Marvin said, well, Daddy, see that there's this boy down in the next block. Got this bicycle he's been trying to sell me for $18. And I can't figure out whether I should try to get him down to $7.95 or steal the motherfucker. Oh, yeah. I do a lot of drunk stories on the truck stop thing. I like drunk stories. Of course, I like drunks. Shit, I dig drunks. I'm one of them. I can communicate with drunks. I like a story about the drunk hanging on a lamppost near a bus stop. Had a great big old German shepherd sitting next to him. Guy walked up to catch the bus, looked at the drunk, said, hey there, how are you? Said, does your dog bite?
Drunk said, shit, shit, no.
Guy reached down to pat the German shepherd. Arr! Goddamn dog took half his arm off. Said, you lying son of a bitch. I thought you said your dog didn't bite.
Drunk said, well, shit. That ain't my dog.
All right. Like a story about the little boys walking down the street, had a little doggy on a string. Funny looking little doggy. Had little short legs and a great big mouth and a long tail. Come on, this drunk had a great Dane. The drunk said to that little boy, I'm going to have my dog eat your dog up. Said, please don't do that, mister. I've only had him 2 days.
Drunk said, fuck you. Sick you.
Great Dane made a pass, and the little dog jumped up, just ripped the throat out of the Great Dane.
Drunk stand there saying, God damn, kid. What kind of fucking dog is that?
Little boy said, well. But before I painted him yeller and named him Spot, he is an alligator. Yeah. Yeah. Y'all ever stop that truck stop just north of Richmond? Gerald truck stop, they got a waitress in there named Evie Mae Harper. Beautiful girl. Evie Mae works in there. And I remember one time she called the police station. I stopped by there about 2 weeks ago. Said, y'all better send a squad car. Said, there's a Democrat sitting over in one of my booths jacking off. Dispatcher said, well, goddamn, Evie Mae, what makes you think he's a Democrat? She said, well, if he is a Republican, he'd be fucking somebody. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Remember back in school, we used to do them old limericks. Remember them old limericks we used to do, how corny they were? Like there was a young man from Boston. He bought him a baby Austin. There's room for his ass and a gallon of gas, and his balls fell out and he lost. Remember that? Remember that? He was a young man from Trent. His dick was so long that it bent. To save himself trouble, he stuck it in double. Instead of coming, he went. Remember all them old horny ass, hair ass limericks? Said there was a young man from Paris that boogered an ape in a tree. What it produced is horrid. All ass, no forehead, 3 balls and a purple goatee. Said there was a young man from the Cape, boogered a British ape,
The ape said, oopsie, you're the yin-yang square. You booger me all out of shape. Oh, remember the one said there was a young couple named Kelly? They found them stuck belly to belly because in their haste they'd gotten the paste instead of the petroleum jelly. Said there was a young lady from Ann Arden who was Frenching a friend in the garden. Friend said, I'd like to know where does all this stuff go? The young lady said, beg pardon? Yeah. Yeah. There was a young lady named Alice that pissed in the Catholic chalice. But it wasn't for relief, for religious belief is pure Presbyterian malice. Oh, there was a young nympho named Alice, used a dynamite stick for a phallus. They found her vagina in South Carolina and bits of her ass about Dallas. There was a young man named Calhoun whose mother was a whore in a saloon. But he hadn't the luck to be raised by a fuck. He is scraped off the sheet with a spoon. Here lies the bones of Screwy Dick. At birth he was blessed with a corkscrew prick. His life he spent in the futile hunt to find the girl with a corkscrew cunt. Well, he finally found her, but then fell dead. Son of a bitch had a left-hand thread. Have a special dedication. This is for Bust Me, Roofer, and Charlie. Fuck ya, fuck ya, fuck ya, F-U-C-K-Y. Fuck ya, fuck ya, fuck ya, F-U-C-K-Y. I really hate your fucking guts. I'd like to kick you in the nuts. Fuck yeah, fuck yeah, F-U-C-K-Y. Heard about the girl worked in the truck stop just out of Birmingham, Alabama. You heard of Birmingham. God damn, you can get bargains there in Birmingham. That's true. You buy a great big old piece of pussy in Birmingham for $10. I done it last time I was there. Lots of bargains going around Birmingham. Heard about the truck stop waitress worked in the truck stop just a little bit north on I-65, just a little bit north of Birmingham. Brenda Bishop was her name. Brenda was out one time just a flagging down traffic, had the hood of her car up, and a highway patrolman pulled up. Alabama highway patrolman got out of his patrol car, spit some tobacco juice, walked out back to Brenda. Said, what's the trouble, miss? She said, I just got raped by a Carolina freight driver. Said, what do you mean got raped by a Carolina freight driver? Said, well, my car stalled, and I got out and raised the hood, and I was getting under looking at the motor to see what was wrong, and somebody come up behind me, pulled the goddamn hood down on me, and helped me there, and raped me from behind, and then got in his truck and drove off. This Carolina freight driver done. Highway patrolman said, what'd they look like, Brenda? She said, damn, fine though. He said, well, shit. How do you know he's a Carolina freight driver? She said, well, he had a great big belt buckle and a little bitty Peter. You can tell them Carolina freight drivers. Run across a fellow from Sharon Motor Lines there in Birmingham one time. One of the drivers named Thomas Tucker, hell of a guy. Hell of a nice guy. Talking to him one time, Thomas said, Tracy, I had the worst piece of ass last night I ever had in my life. I said, goddamn, Tommy. How was it?
He said, wonderful.
Oh, he was flaky. I'll tell you that. Tommy was a drunk, too. I liked Tommy. Heard out the Johnson truck driver was in the truck wreck, had both legs broken, woke up in the hospital, had both his legs in traction. Looking around the bed, he saw this little thing, said, nurse's call button. Pushed the button, the voice came out of the little grill in the wall, said, yes, what is it? He said, lady, I got a shit. And the nurse just came tearing ass back to him, said, that's terrible. Don't you realize that's connected to the intercom? Said, everybody at the desk heard what you said, that's awful. When you got to do something like that, say number two. He said, well, I'm sorry, lady, I didn't mean to fuck up. She said, just hush, and I'll get you bedpan. That afternoon, they brought another guy put in the bed next to him. This poor son of a bitch woke up, had both arms and legs strung out in traction. Came out from under the anesthetic. He's going, oh, oh, I got a shit bad. Johnson truck driver said, goddamn, if you ain't got a sack full of trouble. Said, you can't even reach the button, can you? Said, I'll help you. Pushed the button again. The voice came out of the grill in the wall. Said, yes, what is it? Said, y'all better get somebody back here in a goddamn quick hurry. This son of a bitch in the bed next to me's got a shit worse than I had to this morning. He ain't even got no number yet, you know. Oh, yeah.
Thank you for Mr. Truck Stop Team Tracy.